600 mark, and Disruptive led the way. It's Disruptive with his ears pricked, doing it pretty well by a length, running second over on the outside. Salubrious just holding Necklet in a pocket. Pure Gems fourth, and now being ridden along down on the inside. Demons and Dust, Arcadia Prince, followed by Private Dancer and Reykjavik last of all. But Disruptive kicked away. It allowed Necklet to get now out of that pocket, and she's after Disruptive at the 200. Disruptive the leader. Here comes Necklet, though. It's Necklet coming at Disruptive. They're fighting it out. Further back is Arcadia Prince starting to run on. It's Necklet. Arcadia Prince is flying on the outside. Necklet, Arcadia Prince split it together. Not sure. Arcadia Prince got a dive in right on the line at Necklet. Could have got up, but it's close. Disruptive third. Rattling from last is Reykjavik. And they were followed back behind them. Private Dancer at the head of the others then. Salubrious, Pure Gem, and a long last is Demons and Dust. Arcadia Prince will get the right bobbin on the line, written by William Pike. Number five, Arcadia Prince, grabbing Necklet. Big performance for the three-year-old that graduated out of an all-age maiden at York. Necklet getting into the clear as Disruptive booted to the front soon after straightening, allowed the favourite to get out from the pocket back inside of Salubrious. Arcadia Prince was right behind Salubrious. Pike pulled it to the outside. Necklet hitting the front after having a great battle with Disruptive, but it was Arcadia Prince with Pike willing it to the line, and the Piero gelding has just got there on the post. Arcadia Prince over Necklet, Disruptive in third placing. For Peter's Investments, trained by Grant and Alana Williams, ridden by William Pike at $4 and $1.40, defeating nine, Necklet by Schnitzel from Visited, Fred Kersley, and Fred Kersley Jr. in the saddle, $1.40, for Disruptive, a reset, Lady Phoebe gelding for Chris Wells, A. Anderson, Brad Willison, Gary Dickey, Jay Massey, John Farrick, trained by Lindsay Smith and ridden by Daniel Stake, $2.60. As we wait for the officials to be posted, but that's how they'll read here after the running of race number three, and a nice effort by Reykjavik, who came from last and finished off the race well, although soundly beaten. So Pike again has picked a pocket early on in the program, day one back at Ascot, this time with Arcadia Prince getting the dive in, a son of the champion, Piero. The next event of the day will be the Meyer Sprint over 1,100 metres at 8 minutes after three. There are no changes to the next on the card as we take you back. The G-man is there, Gareth Hall, and he's with the managing part owner, Bobby Peters, after this last stride victory of Arcadia Prince.
Bob Peters joins me, Mac, and he's pretty happy because Arcadia Prince, that was some effort today, Bob.
Yeah, it was good. It was good to see another Piero win. That's three for today.
Piero's low flying at the moment, and this horse settled well back and gave some quality gallopers a bit of a start, but you must have been impressed with that last 200.
Yes, we've always thought that he was a nice horse.
Where do you go from here? Has it always showed you promise back home?
Yes, yes. I thought he was our best male this year, but he's probably have to prove that.
I think he might have went a long way of proving that today. What's your goal? What's your dream this campaign with him? Is he a Guineas horse?
Oh, well, that's obviously where you go. There's a fair ether in 3 weeks and then the Guineas a couple of weeks after that.
Could be the start of a big day, Bob.
Oh, we hope so, yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you.
There's Bob Peters there, our leading owner and breeder, and Arcadia Prince. Very impressive today out in the centre of the track. Gave good horses, a good buffer at the 200-metre mark, but the way it hit the line, an exciting galloper, Matty.
Yeah, wasn't going to take long before the famous Cerise and White Colours scored on opening day at Ascot, and I'll be keen to get William Pike's thoughts on that last 200 because really jumped out of the ground when given something to chase. Was given a nice ride right from the get-go, was comfortable throughout, but really clicked on the speed over the last 200 metres. That's win number 27 for William Pike in the city so far this season. And Grant and Alana Williams take their record to 16 wins in the city for the season. This is obviously win number two at start number two for Arcadia Prince. And no doubt there'll be better things in store going forward.
123.4, the smash the clock the last 600. What's that? 35.54. Arcadia Prince defeats the filly Necklet. Disruptive was really good after setting the pace back in third. Fourth home was Reykjavik, the two horse. So 5.94 and two. Willie just having a chat to Grant and Alana. and Bob Peters there before jumping on the scales. Matty Kelly will be catching up with the Wizard. His first winner of the Ascot season takes him only the three races to bring that up. So Willie jumps on those scales, and Matty, you'll be catching up with WA's leading rider.
Yeah, absolutely. Another good ride there from William Pike. He's, I'll say on fire, but he's always on fire. William, keen to get a feel for this youngster. You've obviously ridden a few good youngsters in the past. Where does this fire kind of give you a feel?
He probably lacks the brilliance of a few of the others that I like, but I tend to be a bit of a bad judge, so he's a nice horse.
Just, we're talking about that final furlong. What kind of feel did he give underneath you when he really stretched out?
A nice feel, obviously. Any horse hitting the line feels pretty good, but I didn't think I was going to be able to win from where I was. I thought I had too much to do, and the other horse with the light weight had too much of a break on me. I was really happy with the way he toughed it out. Like, he sprinted hard, and then when his sprint was done, he still kept toughing it out all the way to the line.
Well done.
Thank you.
William Pike there. He's building a nice relationship with this horse, who is only at start number three today, but has ridden it for a second and a win prior to today, and also in three trials. So the partnership's going well.
He's a good horse, Acadia Prince. Keep an eye for him for the bigger three-year-old races heading towards our carnival. Can't wait for the next race. The four set down for 3:08. It's the Myer Sprint over the 1,100 metres. It sees State Solicitor return. Kuiperinha looking to bounce back. Dainty Tess, Lockroy, it's a beauty coming up at 3:08. We'll be back to have a look at these horses in the yard shortly here on opening day at Ascot.